In our galaxy, stars are distributed such that there is a star roughly every light year. The actual distance between them depends on where we are within the galaxy. Stars are closer together near the center, and they are spread farther apart in, for example, our neighborhood, the outer spiral arms. The closest star to our sun is a little over 4 light years away, but even at this relatively close distance, getting to it may prove impractical. The distances to even our closest stellar neighbors is daunting, the voyage plagued by the painfully slow speeds we are forced to abide. The current state of our technology limits how fast we're able to go. Our foreseeable future does not seem to disclose a path to enabling the very fast speeds required for convenient and speedy interstellar journeys. As an example, let's take a look at how our current interstellar probes are doing. The Pioneer 10 and 11 and the Voyager 1 and 2 probes are all on a trajectory out of our solar system and will eventually reach the stars. As of March 27, 2011, Voyager 1, the most distant of the probes, was 116 astronomical units, or 17.5 billion kilometers away, and it is speeding away at 17 kilometers every second. If we include its circular trajectory as it left Earth and passed the outer planets, the Voyager 1 probe has traveled a total of 19 billion kilometers since it was launched in 1977. Now that it has finally left the boundaries of our solar system, its speed isn't likely to change very much in the future. So we can use Voyager's current speed to answer the question, how long will it take to get to the stars? At this velocity, Voyager is on pace to traverse one light year in 17,500 years. Slowly but surely, both Voyager probes will reach the stars. In about 40,000 years, Voyager 1 will roam within 1.6 light years of the star AC 793888 in the constellation Camelopardalis. In 296,000 years, Voyager 2 will pass within 4.3 light years of Sirius, the sixth closest star to us in the constellation Canis Major. These are the fastest vehicles ever constructed by human beings, and their arrival time to the stars is measured in tens of thousands of years. To take almost 300,000 years to travel to the sixth closest star does not make for practical, convenient journeys within our galaxy. Either we must invent new technologies to speed up our spacecraft, or build generation ships that would land our very distant descendants on the shores of another world. Pioneers 1 and 2, along with the Voyager probes, are inching their way into the vast reaches of interstellar space. While the Pioneer spacecraft are no longer functioning, both of the Voyager probes are still active. Still recording data, their distant, feeble signals reaching Earth in a whisper. As they finally make their way past the closest stars to our sun, they will act as our emissaries, carrying an interstellar greeting card filled with images and sounds of the planet that sent them on their way. It isn't likely that anyone will ever open our greeting card, but the fact that every probe we've launched outside of our solar system carries one reflects the hope that if anyone does, they've likely managed to survive the great filter and are successfully living among the stars.